Guys, we got a pretty awesome product here to check out and review today. First, I want to say thanks to the company OneLeaf for sending this out to me. I always like to fully disclose anytime that I get any products sent to me or any emails sent to me to see if I'll do product reviews, that this is a free product that was sent to me in return for a video review here on the channel. I've said it over and over again, I'm going to say it again real quick. Anything that I put on the channel is something that I firmly believe in. There's been numerous products that's been sent to me in the past that just cheaply made, poorly made, poor quality, whatever it might be, that I wouldn't use myself, and I'm not going to just simply make a video on it and pump it out to my viewers. I put a lot of time into the channel. Anything that's sent to me for a product review is fully reviewed by me and something that I actually would use myself. So that part's out of the way, but want to thank them for sending this out to me. I'll make sure and link this product down below so you guys can check it out after the video, but I think you guys are going to really like this after we go through the specs here and then show you guys towards the end some outside daytime footage as well as some nighttime footage. So getting right into it, you guys saw there at the beginning of the video just how quick and easy this is to pop off of the scope itself. And what we're doing here is we're simply taking a regular daytime optic that you would use out in the field during daytime that's not night vision capable. And it simply turns that daytime optic into a digital night vision scope. By way of doing that, it takes this clamp-on mount here. The box that I received from OneLeaf came with three different size mounting brackets, and all this simply does is just mounts over the rear of the scope, and then you clamp it down with these two Allen head screws. That way you can still use this in daytime and just leave that on there all the time if you want to, or you can take it on and off. Either way is fine. But then you have this, which you just simply take it, and you can kind of hear, hopefully you can hear, just how well this locks into place right there. Everything mounts up really solid, really firm. And one thing, guys, I mentioned there in the beginning, you know, I always want to review and provide videos on things that I would use, things that I believe in. But whenever I got my hands on this, I was really surprised for the price point. Right now they're currently listing at $300 on their website. I'll make sure, like I say, and link that down below. But I was really surprised when I got my hands on this. This is, you know, really well thought out. You guys can see there on the back, I'm going to show you some close-up views. This thing is just really well put together. We'll take just a little bit of time here and go through some of the specs. Don't want to bore you guys with all that, but just go through some of the highlights of it. We'll get into a few of the specs here real quick. On the back, hopefully that focuses well. You'll notice this nice control panel layout. Got all your options from IR brightness settings to zoom. This does have a 4 to 24 power zoom, and also a 1 to 3 power digital zoom. You got a button back here on the back that controls your laser. The laser is actually located here on the front. You'll notice this right here. This is very nice for down coyotes out in the field, whether it be a chopped cornfield or a hay field, whatever it might be. Sometimes those dogs on the longer shots are a little bit hard to locate. So you get your dog down, put your laser on it, and then that's going to lead you right to where the dog is, because sometimes not being behind the night vision and just out there with field lights, it's a little bit difficult to recover them. Right here is your IR. Like I mentioned earlier, the IR has six settings, 1 through 6. You simply take this and pull it out to allow yourself to get more range with the IR light. Longer distances, you would want it out like that. In close is more kind of like a flood setting. Down here is a cap where your 18650 battery fits. I do like the fact that this runs off of 18650s. Those are pretty easy to find. And then right here, of course, is the mechanism that connects to the rear mount on the scope. And that just clicks right into place with that. And then back here is your diopter. Once you get this set to your eye, you should never have to touch this again. What this is basically to add some sharpness to up close objects. For instance, if you're looking at your menu, you want your lettering, your numbering to be in complete focus. The diopter helps dial that in. Right here is your focal adjustment. This right here is kind of like a focal adjustment on a scope. It's pretty much exactly the same thing. The in closer, you know, you're gonna have to dial in for in close shots. And then once you get out further, you'll want to adjust that to get the best clarity possible. That's super easy to reach up and spin. You can see there I'm spinning that. It's just real easy to manipulate. Flipping it over here to the other side, right here you've got a nice weatherproof rubber flip cap. And on here, you're going to find a port to plug in some headphones. You're going to find here a micro USB. This is where you would plug in an external battery pack if you want to run one of those. And then up here is your spot to put in your micro SD card. This does allow up to 256 gigabyte SD cards, which is very nice. Plenty of storage. This unit does do 1080p full HD video and as well as HD photos. You have the option to select between the two. There's not really a way that I can show you what the onboard menu looks like once you hit the menu button back here, but I can tell you right now it's very, very intuitive, very easy to get around in, and just really straightforward. Tons of options within there as far as contrast, sharpness, brightness, all kinds of different things to adjust your picture. Of course, date, time. You can actually leave the scope on the unit. Don't even have to take the micro SD out of the card, and you can check and replay your photos and videos within the unit. Look through them actually through the scope. I thought that was very neat. You'll see here, this is a standard iCup that comes with it, but they do add or put an additional one in the box that is a little bit longer. So if you want to use that, that's always an option. One thing that you will notice whenever you get this clip on night vision is you want to make sure the piece that this connects to, which is on the rear piece, the rear eyepiece of your scope, you want to make sure the piece on the scope is perfectly straight up and down with the crosshair on your scope, because what you're going to notice, and you're actually going to see it in the footage that I show you here in a little bit, if that mount is a little bit off, just ever so slightly, this is going to cant and make the crosshairs look crooked. Even though I know my scope is true and accurate and perfectly level and on plane, if this is canted just a little bit, ever so slightly, it's just going to show that up in the video of this unit, which is really not a huge deal if you're shooting, you know, fairly up close. To be honest, it's more just like a nitpicky type thing that shows up to the naked eye. You'll be able to see it here in the video. But that's just one thing I would point out. Just make sure you get this perfectly straight up and down. Don't leave it canted left or right. You can use this as a handheld scanner if it's not hooked up to the rifle, which I think that would be very nice. And one thing I've also found, the less busy, less cluttered your crosshair is on your scope, the better, the more picture you're going to get, the better picture quality you're going to get, I guess you would say, through this device, just because hash marks kind of, you know, fill in the screen a little bit. Simple crosshair works really well on one of these, but that's all personal preference. The hash marks, bullet drop compensator, BDC reticles, all that stuff will work just fine. Just letting you know what gives you the best picture. But that's enough of the overview here. The specs are all on the website. That's going to be linked down below. We'll get outside and we'll get some actual footage through this. So here we are outside, just giving you guys an idea of what it looks like in daylight. Should come through pretty clear on your end, but it's pretty dang clear. Looking right down through the scope. This scope here has a base magnification of 3 power. It's a 3 to 15 power. I would assume you're going to get a little clearer picture if you've got a true 1 power scope, like a nice 1 to 8 or 1 to 10, but this is a Vortex 3 to 15 Strike Eagle. Just looking around, I'll give you guys an idea. Those hay bales in the back are a little bit out of focus. I'll try to bring those into focus with this knob here. There you go. Kind of brings those in. These pieces of equipment here, I'm going to guess, are 70 yards probably. A bird flying around there. This focus is super easy to manipulate and turn. This tower here is probably 250 to 300 yards away.
and see how well it will focus in way out there. Bring it back out tonight and look at some stuff. This barn over here is about 115 yards away. And I'll make sure and shine these again tonight. Alright guys, here we are back outside at night. Pointing back to this smaller shed over here that we shined in the daylight. I don't know if it's going to show up in the screen or not, but right here is IR setting number one. I'm just going to kind of scroll through and show how much better it gets with each click. Once again, this is just the factory IR that comes with the clip-on night vision. There's number two, setting three, 4, 5, and 6. That's your max setting right there. Let's see how well everything shows up. There's an extension cord right here in the crosshair. This reticle system on this is pretty busy, so it kind of clouds what you guys are seeing. But man, it just shows a lot of detail. Pretty awesome. Also, I want to note, I was noticing in my daylight video, I probably had this device canted just a little bit, so it might show on your end that the crosshair is canted. That's just a matter of readjusting the bezel, the housing, whatever you want to call it, the attachment that goes on the end of your scope, so the night vision clips right into it. I probably just had that a little bit skewed. A little bit off, but no big deal. I'm going to swing the rifle here on setting 6 and try to find this tower that was about 250 to 300 yards away. Kind of hard to see out here at night by the naked eye, but I think I can find it in the scope. There it is. That's what we saw earlier. Shows up really well, about 300 yards. I think the box on this said visibility up to 328 yards, but I don't know, be interested to test that. I think it might be a little more capable of that, really. I'm going to walk over and get a better view of that equipment that we looked at earlier. Alright, I moved over here towards this equipment. Exactly where we were in daylight, looking at the equipment. We're on IR setting 1. There's 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Very, very clear. I'm going to try to find focus here. About right in there, probably. Up everything really well. Man, this thing is impressive. Turn any daylight optic into night vision scope. And a nice daytime recording capability too. Gonna be very handy. It's gonna be awesome for squirrel hunting. Have to try it out on the 22. There's the bigger barn right over here. I think we looked at this earlier today. Pretty impressive stuff.
So there it is, guys. You can see the footage there. I'm super impressed with this. Hopefully you guys are. Like I mentioned earlier, the less busy, the less cluttered your crosshair is, the better picture you're going to get through this unit. But man, I've been super impressed with this. I can't wait till coyote season gets here. Gonna be running this on a few rifles, just because of course I only have one thermal scope, And then I'll also be using this for squirrel hunting and also hopefully some beaver shooting as well. So stay tuned for that stuff. But any questions at all, make sure and comment down below. Try to get back to those as quickly as I can. And I'm also going to throw up a card here for you guys to take a look at on some previous pretty exciting coyote footage for anybody that hasn't seen that yet. Those seem to get pretty good views and are in pretty high demand. So we're looking forward to getting back into coyote season, getting back into the thermal game, and then also incorporating this just a little bit. But any questions at all, make sure and let me know. Looking forward to what this season brings. Happy hunting. Be safe. See you guys. Bye.